They're serving up an income suite in the basement.
Erin wants to upgrade from her small downtown condo.
This one is very pretty.
It is awesome.
Perfect for a princess.
To make it happen, this self-described princess needs my help to find a house with income property potential.
As I like to say, unspoiled basement. How would you like yours?
Gutted. Straight up.
She'll buy it.
This is my new home.
I'll renovate it.
Whoa!
And in the end, she'll have a property she can bank on.
More quiet, it's really noisy. I back onto an alley. This is Charlotte and this is Elsie. For me and for the dogs, some more space and a yard is really important.
If Erin wants to trade up from her cramped condo, she's gonna need a property with income potential.
I'm a single woman. That's one reason why I need a rental apartment, because I'm working with one income. I'd really like to get Scott's input about, you know, what my options are and also how I can make the most money.
Saving up for and buying your first income property, that's hard. Doing it on one income, that's even harder. Trust me, I know, because that's how I got started.
I'm having one of my good friends, Alana, come and help me with this whole process. She actually owns her own home and has done some renovations, so she's going to be my go-to girl.
Oh, but I do need new nail polish. Who ever runs out of nail polish?
Erin is a princess, loves the pretty things. I'm hoping Erin will agree to live somewhere that's a little bit less fancy.
We can agree to disagree on that.
You'll see. I think you'll come around.
I'm going to help Erin find a home that she loves and then build her an income suite so she can afford it. Erin has a budget of $450,000 to purchase and renovate her first home and income property. We're going to look at a bunch of listings. The first one is a detached bungalow close to a college. Good morning.
Hi, nice to see you.
Nice to see you as well. Are you guys ready to go in and have a look?
Yes, absolutely.
Let's do it. Feast your eyes.
Oh, wow.
Like a split level?
It's almost a raised bungalow. So we're coming in kind of halfway here.
Okay.
So what we're looking for is to keep your mortgage as low as possible by finding something that's got great potential for an income suite. That is if you're happy with the upstairs. Because you need to be happy with your home, right?
Yep.
Good. And then I'll make sure you can afford it.
Great.
So let's take a look around.
Oh, boy.
Oh, wow. Still got lots of stuff left in this thing.
Come on, who's got a booth in their kitchen like this, huh?
Everybody.
These countertops are just climbing the walls back here.
I don't know. It is pretty dated.
See, this is probably a lot different than the condo you live in now.
Yes. The condo is completely updated. Everything is new. So I've been a little spoiled.
Don't discount this house right away. I know it's a little bit ugly, but it can be fixed up. Lots of living space in here. And these hardwood floors are in great condition. Look at these floors. Let's check out these bedrooms. That's going to tell us a lot more about the place. First bedroom, good size.
Cool. Can I check out this closet?
Please do.
I have a walk-in right now, and although I can walk in it, I don't know, it's a bit different than what I'm used to.
Even better, how about an entire room as a closet?
Down the hall, there are two good-sized bedrooms.
Oh, wow.
But under all that wallpaper and carpet, they're in great shape.
Hardwood floor is intact in every room, in every closet, in a whole place.
Oh. Okay.
I mean, the tile is ugly, but it is in great shape.
I know that Scott's gonna help me out with the basement, but the upstairs is all me.
Question is, what's downstairs?
This is a lot of green.
So let's take a look at what we got up here. So this is good. This is actually what I want to see, is that we've got lots of room to put our sound insulation in there. And don't be deceived by all the dark paneling, which makes it feel small, because there's tons of room. Holy cow.
Oh.
All the single ladies to the bar, please. So, today we are serving up an income suite in the basement. Ooh. How would you like yours?
Gutted, straight up.
There's also a bathroom down here.
This is actually really good.
And a nice size utility room.
So the house itself, pretty awesome.
I need to see the backyard for the dogs.
Yeah.
Fenced in yard.
Good. That's very important.
That's pretty
big.
Before we check in with the princess, let's check in with the jester. What do you think of the place?
I think it's a great place. I think it's got everything you need.
It could use a little more shine. It's just not as pretty as I'd hoped for.
I know.
But you could take your time with the cosmetic upgrades required in the huge four-bedroom main floor unit. It's outdated, but in great shape. The real potential is downstairs, where we'd reconfigure the space to create a three-bedroom apartment with an open-concept kitchen and living room, perfect for the local student rental market.
Brace yourself a little bit, because it's a bit expensive and it's pushing your limits. But from an investment standpoint, this house is killer. The house is listed at $430,000, and it needs a $50,000 renovation. Your total budget here would be about $480,000.
Okay.
But that's not the end result. You're going to get about $1,500 a month in rent.
Wow.
So that brings your mortgage payments down to about $350 a month. You're living here for about the same cost as condo fees.
When I hear the numbers, it does make good sense.
So let's go look at something that's a little prettier, maybe.
Awesome.
Sound good?
Sounds great.
All right.
Follow me. This first property, although the price point is good, when you add on the renovation, it's over her total budget. But I'm trying to get her to look at the bottom line. Because if you actually look at what it's costing her every month, it's pretty low.
That would be a good investment.
Yeah, I think so too.
But I don't know, there's so many renovations to do. That kitchen was so old looking.
Yeah.
Second house is way out there. I don't know if I've ever been this far out of town.
Good morning. Erin wants to trade her cramped condo for a house with a yard.
I want to have a house of my own, but I'm going to need rent income.
The first house had some dated decor.
I don't know. It's a bit different than what I'm used to.
But the income from the basement could make it all worthwhile.
You're living here for about the same cost as condo fees.
Now I'm showing Erin how much her single income can buy her outside of the city.
Is this one a little prettier for you?
This one is very pretty.
I see you smiling already.
Mm-hmm.
So you wanted something pretty, you wanted something cute, but you also want that financial opportunity?
Yep.
We got you prettier, but we got a little further from the city. So let's go take a look.
Okay. Oh, wow.
So pretty.
I like it.
It's a sign. This property is protected.
Protected, yeah. Wow, this is a very fancy dining room.
Fit for a king or a princess.
Oh,
it's a great space.
Beautiful.
Really
so
nice.
Bright.
Wow. We got dog books, dog toys, wow. Dog pictures.
And look at the princess mask.
And the princess mask. I mean, the place looks pretty good.
Yeah.
I don't have any major concerns yet. Nice staircase here.
Upstairs, we find a bathroom in great condition and two neutral but good-sized bedrooms.
It's just kind of boring, but I can spice it up.
Sure.
Let's take a look at the master bedroom.
Wow! This is huge!
This is not what I was expecting.
This is
awesome.
Perfect for a princess.
We better check out this closet space.
Okay, good size.
Good.
You're happy with that closet?
Very.
Because I think you're going to be even happier in a second.
Oh, this is great. Oh, wow.
Oh, my gosh.
Look at the tub.
She's very quickly feeling at home here. So very quickly, I need to make sure we can make some money before she completely falls in love. Upstairs is good. Main floor is good. Question now.
Can we make money downstairs?
Oh!
Guys, don't be so disappointed. It's a bathroom.
I was hoping this was a separate entrance. It is not. It's a powder room. So a separate entrance would need to be put on this back wall. Unfinished. As I like to say, unspoiled basements.
Wow,
it just keeps going.
Do you see what I see?
No.
I think I see something wrong here.
Okay.
And possibly right there.
Oh! You picked the right person to go shopping with you.
Yes.
Me. But she's doing pretty good, too.
Yeah.
It's not a big enough crack to be a structural issue. But guess what it is big enough for? Water coming through. And I can see evidence on the wall of the moisture. But typically, cracks like these, we can do an epoxy fill, which means that we can fix the problem from in here for about a few hundred bucks a crack.
We're kind of starting from scratch down there. There's obviously a lot of work to do. But
I really like this house. It really kind of checked all the boxes in terms of space and layout.
I don't know what boxes you've got to be checked, but they're not.
What is it missing?
It's missing a door for your income property.
Yeah,
it's missing an income property for your income property.
Scott's going to look after that.
So what do you guys think of the backyard?
Wow.
Perfect.
This is perfect. It's beautiful. Some of the cracks and some of the things to work on are a little bit intimidating for me, but overall I really like it. It's just, it's really far out. It would be a long commute.
This house is listed at $380,000. So the price point is better.
Yeah.
But there's more work to be done to put in a separate unit. We need to put in the separate entrance. We need to fix some of the foundation issues, and then we have to build the whole income suite.
And that's going to take your entire budget. We transform the raw basement into a large one-bathroom and two-bedroom apartment with a nice-sized kitchen, a good living space, and a dedicated entrance. Now, the upper unit, however, is beautiful, modern, and ready for you to move in.
I would budget at least $70,000 to do that.
Wow.
Overall, you're in for $450,000, which on a monthly basis would cost you about $1,750 in mortgage and loan repayment on the renovation.
Okay.
The market around here, a two-bedroom apartment, really tops out around $1,000 a month. So you could take your $1,750 a month mortgage payment and chop that down to $750 a month.
Okay.
And upstairs, you'd get exactly what you want.
This one gets me emotionally. And I don't know if anybody would come visit me all the way up here.
Not me.
I'll come visit.
Okay, me too.
That's all. We'll take it. It was beautiful. It was so nice. I just loved how it was decorated. I loved how bright it was.
This last house, boy, was it pulling on her emotions. It's pretty. It's nice. You know, I feel so happy here, which is good. I want her to love her home. She has this difficult task of balancing her emotional desire for a home and her financial and fundamental requirement for an income suite. Let's take a look.
That makes me very nervous and very grossed out.
I'm helping Aaron break out of the condo market and into a home with an income property.
I need a rental apartment because I'm working with one income.
The decor of the first house left a lot to be desired, but the numbers didn't.
You're living here for about the same cost as condo fees.
Everything about the second house was perfect.
It's awesome.
Perfect for a princess.
Except for the location. Now we're going back into the city to check out another bungalow.
This is cute.
Really focus on, does this house have the income potential to get you out of your condo and into a home?
Right.
All right, okay. Let's take a look. Mm-hmm. Oh!
Oh, wow!
It has been updated.
Yeah, it's nice and open.
Was not expecting that.
No, this is a lot newer than I thought it was going to be.
Nice new windows in the front.
Yeah, it's very nice.
The dogs would like this view.
So they've put in paw lights, they put in some crown molding. Let's keep looking around. Rest of the kitchen tucked in here.
Interesting layout.
Oh, gas stove.
Oh, gas stove is good.
Oh. There's water coming up through the seams of the laminate.
Oh.
We have a fridge line for the ice machine and water maker. It looks like this one has been leaking. Once moisture gets into the laminate, it curls up and it dries that way. Could have been an easy fix, but it went a little too late.
Yeah.
So you'd have to pull it back, probably out of the entire kitchen at this point.
Down the hallway, there are two smaller bedrooms, a well-maintained bathroom, and a master bedroom.
Check the closet.
Walk in.
I am not thinking
So upstairs is pretty good, other than the leaking fridge and the damage it's caused here. But this is what I want to investigate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, this is a big space. Finished laminate floors.
Wow, yeah.
It's a different laminate than upstairs.
Ding, 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 ding.
So this could be a couple things. It could be rodents.
What else could it be?
A family of rodents that are nesting in a
certain section. So it could be one rodent. The other option is many rodents.
And they are defecating in the same spot over and over again. It creates a stain on the ceiling.
That makes me very nervous and very grossed out. There could be rodents in the ceiling and the walls that...
You got another bedroom down here.
Oh, it's kind of like a dungeon in here.
It's a little bit small. More storage for the bedrooms.
That's good.
No,
not a closet.
What? Come on in.
Wow.
You're talking an 18-inch door. That doesn't work.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, once you're in here, it's not so bad, though, is it?
It opens up quite a bit.
The installation of the tile looks pretty good. We've got no leaks. We've got no cracks. No, it's silly that, I mean, this tiny little bedroom, that narrow little washroom, because I know it's a bungalow, which means it's the space down here should be the exact same size as upstairs.
Oh, that's something good.
Unfinished.
Okay. Laundry.
Half unfinished.
It's kind of a kitchen. Maybe it's just kind of a laundry area. Whoa. You can just see how much water there is under there. We've got the fridge line here. We've got moisture coming in, dripping from the ceiling, running down this corner. There's also a crack in the foundation here. There's a little bit of moisture damage down there as well. Now, this puddle we know is from the fridge upstairs, but it looks like there's an older puddle over there that may have come in from the foundation. So this whole area needs a lot of work. But look at the space. I love the size of the space. Your concern still is for the dogs. You want to see...
I want to see the backyard.
Perfect, because I noticed the separate entrance at the back. I want to have a look at that.
Wow.
This is the biggest one we've seen yet.
It's got a nice big deck, Scott.
It's fairly new. And it's pressure treated, low maintenance. Your back door here most likely would become a shared back door with your tenant. My concern is that I know the city has a bylaw about two-unit properties. Yeah. You have to have room for two cars side by side, and right now, there's only a single driveway. There's work to be done outside, there's work to be done inside. I want you to know everything that's at stake with all the properties we're looking at. I mean, we're trying to find something that's princess perfect, right?
It's true. I do like a lot of the features upstairs, and it just feels cozy there.
This property is listed for $350,000. So it's the most affordable of everything that we've seen.
Yeah.
We know that it needs work, and most of it would be down in the basement, where we'd build two bedrooms and an open concept living and dining area. We'd also update the kitchen and the bathroom to complete this cozy basement apartment. You'd live in the three-bedroom suite on the main floor, which has been recently renovated and is in pretty good shape. And I would say it needs at least $60,000 to put in an income suite downstairs. So you're in for a total of $410,000, which runs you about $1,550 a month.
Okay.
But I think a two-bedroom apartment down there would bring in about $1,000 a month. So your real cost would be reduced to $550 a month. But you have to find a property that you're happy with, but that's also going to be affordable. It's going to be up to you to make this decision now.
Okay.
Erin plays up the whole princess thing, but I know she's also got a very practical side because she has saved up a good down payment and she's buying an income property. The only question now is, who's going to make the decision here? Practical Erin or Princess Erin? Erin wants to trade in her cramped downtown condo for a home with some space, but she can't afford it on her single income.
I think in order to get onto the house market, I'm going to need probably a little bit of rent income.
We've seen three properties, and now she needs to make a decision.
Oh my gosh, this is going to be a tough choice.
The detached bungalow would reduce her mortgage the most, bringing it down to $350 a month.
The first house is great in terms of the rental income.
You're living here for about the same cost as condo fees.
But it's a lot of money up front, and it's just so dated inside. I don't know if I can handle that.
I know it's a little bit ugly, but it can be fixed up.
Next, we saw the suburban beauty. That would reduce her mortgage to $750 a month.
This is so pretty. I mean, we know that I love how it looks.
We got you prettier, but we got a little further from the city.
It's so far from everything.
But to think that I could afford to live there is quite appealing.
The city bungalow would reduce her mortgage to $550 a month.
It's going to give you a good return on investment. Lots of space downstairs.
Whoa! You can just see how much water there is under there. It's the most affordable of everything that we've seen.
Yeah.
But we know that it needs work.
It's not as pretty and as spacious as house number two, but certainly coming from my condo, it's tons of space.
That's right.
Okay. Well,
are you good?
I think I'm good.
Cool.
Let's go.
Yeah.
After considering all the options, Erin finally decided, and she bought the city bungalow.
I'm home!
So exciting!
It's within my price range. I can imagine myself living there, and I think that the rental property will be easy to find a tenant for.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And I'm going to get money.
Yes.
She got her home and income property for the asking price of $350,000.
This is my new home.
I forced her not to choose the suburban beauty because it was too far, too big, and your kitchen.
I know. I didn't pick the large bungalow because the asking price plus the renovation costs are just a little bit out of my budget.
Now that she has the house, it's time to decide what to do with it.
Congratulations on the new home.
Thank you.
I want to focus on how to take this house, turn it into two units, and start getting you some cash. And you need to make one more big decision.
Okay.
So option number one, I want to start with an efficient wraparound kitchen with stainless steel appliances. In the corner, we'd install a four-piece bathroom with a tub. The entire apartment is going to get brand new, durable laminate flooring throughout, and on the other side of the rental suite, we'd have enough room to build two good-sized bedrooms. There's a few other things that need to be done. Fire and sound separation, fire doors upstairs. We will have a common laundry area when you first come down the stairs, and even work to be done outside because we need two parking spaces side by side, so your driveway is going to double in size. And if the crack in the foundation is bad, I may have to waterproof that side of the house while we're at it.
You need to tell me, how much is it going to cost?
It is a $60,000 renovation to bring in $1,000 a month.
Okay.
That's going to reduce your mortgage down to $550 a month.
Okay. Let's hear the second option.
Let me tell you what I thought for option number two. We start with this space. We add on to it by opening up this wall. So down here, we'll have a wraparound eat-in kitchen, but we'll have dedicated laundry as well. This will open up the whole space.
Like in option one, the large living area would get a fresh coat of paint and we'd lay laminate flooring throughout the entire apartment. The existing bathroom would get updated with a new sink, new tiles, and new lighting. In this options-only bedroom, we'd paint, hang new window treatments, and then this place would be ready to rent.
You end up with a self-contained one-bedroom unit down here, and then we put laundry upstairs for you. Because it's a cheaper renovation, some money left over for you to do some fixes upstairs.
Okay. How much cheaper is it?
Option number two is a $50,000 renovation. I believe it will bring in $850 a month, and that will reduce your mortgage to $650 a month.
That's a lot to think about.
Look, last big decision, then we get to work.
Mm-hmm. Ultimately, with option one, it's the money.
Basically, how I see it, Aaron, is if you can spend the extra money now, it would be a better option to go with option one, the two bedrooms. And
option two, financially, is just a lot more manageable, a lot more comfortable. It's a tough decision because I have this great team at my disposal now.
That's right.
How are you doing out here?
We're
hemming and hawing.
Yeah, it's a tough call.
Yeah.
Well, what's it going to be? Option number one or option number two?
I'm going with option two.
Option number two, you're going with the one-bedroom layout.
That's right.
That leaves lots of room for you to do some work upstairs as well. One thing left to do. Open that hot tub. I mean, get to work. I'll work up a sweat first. Come on.
All right.
This house, with this renovation, will have a mortgage of $1,500 a month. But the basement suite will rent for $850 a month, which will leave Aaron with a monthly mortgage payment of $650.
That's as long as the renovation goes according to plan. Gang is here. We need to get you guys suited up. Gloves, goggles.
Oh, boy. All right.
You look like business time right there.
I feel it. I feel ready.
I think you missed your calling. You should have been a construction worker.
Probably, yeah.
First thing I think you girls need to do is pull down some cabinets.
Look at that!
Oh, wow.
That was way easier than I thought it was going to be.
Now, with all that out of the way, time to get to the real work.
I'm getting out of the way.
Aaron, this is your house. You bought it. You kill it. Whoa!
Demolition was dirty and messy and hard work, but pretty satisfying.
Had enough of this. There's a few things we need to figure out.
You told me that there might be rodents up there.
There's only one way to find out. Pry them out carefully. You never know what's gonna fall out.
I was so grossed out, I wanted to just turn around and call the whole thing off.
There it is. It's actually condensation coming from the duct line. Any moisture in the air is going to condense on that ductwork. We'll look at the calibration to make sure that that doesn't happen again. Good news is, no rodents.
No rodents. That's a huge relief.
When we came to look at this house, I noticed the moisture problems in the basement. And even though the leak isn't happening right now, I guarantee you the water is still there.
Come up pretty quick. We're dry. We're dry. There it is. And we're wet. Thanks. Oh, do you smell that?
Oh. Once that floor came up, it was just stench.
Let's get this out of here.
Go. Oh, right in the dumpster.
That's a lot of moisture. So the back of the house here has been saturated in water probably multiple times. Do you see the different stains on the floor? All these white stains. I think this is more than just the leaking fridge. If you look at the crack in the foundation, look at the crack continues through the floor. What it looks like is that this whole section of the house has actually gone like kerplunk.
When Scott talked about the whole back corner of the house having just
gone ka-tunk,
that's right, yeah, dropped down, I was freaking out.
This part of the house is sinking. Erin sold her downtown condo and bought a house with potential for an income suite in the basement.
You look like business time right there.
I feel it.
She needs to turn the basement into a moneymaker. But the cracked foundation could put her plan in jeopardy.
The whole back of the house here, her clunk, has sunk.
All I saw was dollar signs going ching, 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 and I...
You know, to have part of the house kind of sinking and settling like that, it's not great. However, it is fairly normal. Cracks in the floor, totally normal. This is very typical. This is your house naturally settling. Okay?
Okay.
It's totally normal to have a few cracks in the walls in a basement. However, there's also signs of water around this one. So I want to bring in my foundation guy, make sure we waterproof everything before we go ahead and finish the space. Let this dry out and let's move our attention over to the bedroom. As we know, the bedroom is a little tight. We need to make this room 33% bigger. You ready to kick?
Yep.
One, two, three.
I just wanted to open this space up and get her excited because she's just spent all of her money on a property plus the cost of the renovation. She's nervous because if we don't get this place done and we don't get a tenant in here, trouble.
This entire wall borders the driveway. Tiny little crack, water issue. Can you fix this from the inside? You can't do like an injection on this, can you?
No, that can't be done because of the hollow, poor nature of the cinder blocks.
Yeah.
You'd be pumping till the cows come home.
Yeah, Scott, I think what we should be doing here is excavator right down to the footing and waterproof it from one end to the other and change the weeping tile, and we're going to be good to go.
That's it, huh? Just everything. I always hope for the best, but plan for the worst. So we have budgeted to do a full foundation waterproofing, but it would be really nice if we didn't have to spend all that money. Unfortunately, we're gonna have to.
Yeah, you're good. You're good, you're good. At least we get to work outside today.
As soon as we started digging up the asphalt, boom. Oh, not good.
Yeah, there it is, yeah.
We've hit something hard. Is that a seam or is it not?
Yeah.
Whoa!
Aaron shows up at the worst possible time. This isn't supposed to be here. This is a concrete pad underneath your asphalt driveway.
One in 50 houses I dig up, we encounter something like this. It's probably another 10 man hours at least.
Pierre, what I am noticing, though, is that there's a couple seams here, or cracks.
So I panicked a little bit. But then, you know, Scott busted out his He-Man muscles and managed to find that they were just in smaller pieces and saved the day, saved my bank account, so all good now.
Heavy. Today we're finally going to get to putting in the new back door. Erin will have her dedicated entrance to the yard. The tenants will have their dedicated entrance to the basement. Everyone will be happy.
To rent it out, starting to actually get some money coming in instead of just money going out.
I know how much Erin needs this apartment done, and she needs the rent coming in. But today, I gotta tell Erin that she's not gonna get what she wanted. Good morning, Erin.
Good morning.
I wanted to talk to you because I have some news, and it's not good. Erin just bought a house, and we're building an income suite so she can afford to live there.
Buying the house, then taking out a loan for the renovations, and not having any money coming in has really made the finances really tight.
But now our renovation schedule is tangled up in red tape. One of the biggest challenges of building legal income suites is dealing with all the bylaw, all the zoning, and all the building code that comes with it. Although everything we're doing is great, now they want me to make changes to plans they've already approved. And Erin's gonna be frustrated when I tell her because it's gonna cost her time and she needs the rent coming in. The inspector, we had some concerns about the extra storage area that we had. He wants there to be access to that extra space from the upstairs apartment. They've now finally approved a new layout. What we need to do is we need to move that storage space over to the bottom of the stairs so that you have access to it and it is not within the tenant's apartment.
Okay, but I'm nervous for how much more this is going to cost.
$1,750.
Okay.
So far, we're already delayed about a week. And I'm assuming we're going to be delayed another 2 weeks based on the changes. So that means you're basically a total of 3 weeks delay. We're going to be missing that first of the month.
The delay in time is really my biggest concern because it's delaying my ability to get income. Well, get to work.
Get to work. All right, that's all I wanted to hear.
With all the hassles and the roadblocks that the city is putting up, I would have given up a long time ago.
Drinks are on me. What's that, a water?
It's a tea. Thanks.
Done.
Without Scott, this never would get done.
No. Nobody likes to be on hold, and our permits were held up, so it's nice to be back here, and everybody showed up. We want to get the job done. We're doing the front yard. We're doing the backyard. We're doing the basement. It's all hands on deck, including Alana and Aaron. I'm putting everybody to work. So let me show you the new apartment, because this is where the door begins into the tenant's space. So the kitchen has moved this way. Haha.
Okay.
All kitchen. And basically what we've done is we've just taken the original plan and we've shifted everything about 12 feet this way. And you actually get this extra room here.
Wow. This is good. This is good.
Let's get you girls suited up and put you to work.
All right.
It's that simple.
All right.
Looks easy, right?
Yeah.
Because it is easy.
Okay.
Here you go.
Okay.
Got it?
Oh, jeez.
You got that?
Pretty heavy. Did it.
Nice.
Keep doing it.
One down.
Yeah.
250 square feet to go. Are you guys curling or are you doing your renovation here? Sweet! You think you're tough? I'm gonna put you to work. We'll just see how tough you are. This is going to be where the dryer vent is going.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll drill a pilot hole and then we'll get you on the SDS on the other side. You ever cored a hole through a foundation before?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
They're actually pretty tough. I won't lie.
Today. We'll see when we get down there. I got something to show you. We came in, we found some water on the floor over in the kitchen area.
Oh man, there's a puddle here.
Mm-hmm.
Or dry on this side.
The water seems to be trailing across the back here.
Take a little video here. Even though it's really tight quarters here, we're going to do our best to inspect it, try to find this problem and resolve it so we can finish up. There's a wet spot. Boom. Dude, it's soaked right here. Is that water dripping down? What are the odds that we just found that? You know what it is? It's pretty hot out.
It is.
I'll bet you she's turned her AC on and there's a leak. We gotta cut this wall open. Hold on. Okay, let's pull some insulation. Can you see it?
Right there.
You know what? Drip line is not into the hole. So it's leaking onto the floor. The fix was as simple as putting the pipe into the drain. Problem solved. Just down to the nuts and bolts of the railing. And then the whole front entrance will be done. New walkway, new driveway, two cars wide, the way the city wants it. We put in a new nice big window here with a new window well, waterproof this side of the building. We've got a dedicated entrance to the tenant's apartment, and we've separated it from Aaron's backyard and given her own separate entrance leading out to the yard. And this is just what we've done outside. Now, the basement has a typical shared laundry setup. The back wall with the new window has been completely waterproof. I mean, we're getting so close to the end. We got the light fixtures in. We have a new layout. The kitchen has landed over here, and I actually like it because we've gained this extra space. It's not just a one bedroom, it's a one plus bedroom. There's the bedroom. We expanded it a little bit so it was bigger, felt more comfortable. We also expanded the entrance to the bathroom so it's so normal. I mean, we're so close to finishing. I can smell it. Actually, I smell paint. Renovations have delays, but this one, a few more delays than normal. So to make up for lost time, Erin has to rent this place out quickly, and she has to rent it out for good money. Will she be able to do either of these things? We'll take it from here.
All right.
Well, we're about to find out. Erin bought a house, and we built a rental suite all on her single income.
Did it!
Nice! Our renovation got delayed by red tape, and we had to change the layout. But finally, the basement apartment is almost done. As a single lady, Erin says she'd be more comfortable living above a female renter. So I've staged the apartment with a bit of a feminine touch. So it appeals to Erin and will also appeal to a renter just like her. Have a look around.
Wow.
Not what you expected.
It's really spacious. The first thing you notice when you come in is how open it feels. In this neighborhood, it's really unusual to find a legal apartment of this stature.
Thank you very much,
my Michelle. Pleasure.
Yeah,
no
I love you? This door.
I know, it's a beautiful door. I love it too. Out of my way.
Out of my way.
Fine.
All right, Erin, after you. It's been a long time coming.
So much wider than I expected.
It's a big space.
The floor is amazing. The lights.
Thank you. I've been waiting for you to say it. I'm like, when is she gonna notice the lights?
It's
that's
so
the Erin factor I put in here.
They're so sparkly.
Yeah, just like,
I feel a little bit overwhelmed. I'm so excited. I'm so proud that that's my house. Like, really, that's sort of the overwhelming feeling is pride in home ownership. Ceiling would feel low, but it doesn't at all. There's quite a lot of storage space.
Yeah.
And I actually really like the color difference. The white cabinets on the bottom and the black on the top.
Mm-hmm.
I got the fridge over there on that side with a little extra storage space.
I can't believe that you can even fit this table in here.
I know. This is a really good sized table. And right. I love it.
You know what the bonus of this layout is? That room right there. That didn't exist in our first option, right?
It's so big. I love everything. I love everything.
What a great spot.
This is incredible. This is perfect for a home office.
Mm-hmm.
If you like this, you're going to love the changes we made to the bathroom.
Look at the size of this doorway.
You can go through it. You don't have to
sideways. Holy smoke.
Look at the floor.
This is nothing like it was before. It feels like a hotel or a spa.
Yeah. There's just so much more room.
And I didn't forget about the leaves.
They're everywhere.
They're everywhere.
And the bedroom.
Wow. Oh, it's so much bigger.
Awesome.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, the headboard.
That is so nice. I love the color, too.
Yeah.
It's so bright.
We've bumped that wall out 4 feet. We haven't encroached too much on the living space, which is great. We went out and looked at a bunch of properties.
I'm very happy I picked this house, and I just couldn't wait to see what the other half of it looked like. So, and now the downstairs is so much nicer than my stuff. It's a bit embarrassing, but it's amazing. I love it.
It was a challenge, but we got an income suite in here, and it was so important because you're doing this by yourself. When you're buying real estate on your own, there's no backup plan.
Yeah.
You have to pay the mortgage no matter what. So putting in this income suite was imperative. You bought this house for $350,000.
Yes.
You spent $50,000 on the renovation.
Yes.
So you've spent $400,000.
Yes.
You okay?
Yeah.
I had an agent come by today and give me a new assessed value on the property. And it was suggested that your house was worth $435,000.
It's amazing.
I like to make sure you win twice, not just once. The cash flow, that's our goal, but the equity, hey, why not win on that as well?
Yeah.
So let's talk about the cash flow. And the real reason you did this is to help with those mortgage payments. You're paying $1,500 a month. We suggested with this renovation that you'd earn an extra $850 a month in rent from this space. And the number that she suggested was $1,100 a month.
That's so exciting.
That's so good. Oh my gosh. That's so much more than I ever thought.
So you're really only paying $400 a month.
That's so good. I feel so relieved about the finances to hear that it's, you know, increased the value of the home and that I'm going to be able to get a little bit more rent than I thought. I'm just really excited to be much more financially stable and be able to put money aside every month for savings. That's a huge peace of mind for me.
I think Erin's made a great decision. She's going to be paying less than she was in a tiny little condo. This is a win-win.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Oh, I get one
too. You did
too?
Pretty good too, kid.
For more information about this show, please visit hgtv.ca.
Question is, what do we do with this?
You pour some wine and you get in. That's right. What you do with it.
Hello? Oh. What are you guys doing in here?
We are working hard here.
Absolutely.
And she picked the house with a hot tub, and there's nothing I can do about that.
Unbelievable. The floor.
This is nothing like it was before. It feels like a hotel or a spa. Yeah.
There's just so much more room.
And I didn't forget about the leaves.
They're everywhere.
They're everywhere.
And the bedroom.
Wow. Oh, it's so much bigger.
Awesome.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, headboard.
That is so nice. I love the color too.
Yeah.
It's so bright.
We've bumped that wall out 4 feet. We haven't encroached too much on the living space, which is great. We went out and looked at a bunch of properties.
I'm very happy I picked this house, and I just couldn't wait to see what the other half of it looked like. So, and now the downstairs is so much nicer than my stuff. It's a bit embarrassing, but it's amazing. I love it.
It was a challenge, but we got an income suite in here, and it was so important because you're doing this by yourself. When you're buying real estate on your own, there's no backup plan.
Yeah.
You have to pay the mortgage no matter what. So putting in this income suite was imperative. You bought this house for $350,000.
Yes.
You spent $50,000 on the renovation.
Yes.
So you've spent $400,000.
Yes.
You okay?
Yeah.
I had an agent come by today and give me a new assessed value on the property. And it was suggested that your house was worth $435,000.
It's amazing.
I like to make sure you win twice, not just once. The cash flow, that's our goal, but the equity, hey, why not win on that as well?
Yeah.
So let's talk about the cash flow. And the real reason you did this is to help with those mortgage payments. You're paying $1,500 a month. We suggested with this renovation that you'd earn an extra $850 a month in rent from this space. And the number that she suggested was $1,100 a month.
That's so exciting.
That's so good. Oh my gosh. That's so much more than I ever thought.
So you're really only paying $400 a month.
That's so good.
I feel so relieved about the finances to hear that it's, you know, increased the value of the home and that I'm going to be able to get a little bit more rent than I thought. I'm just really excited to be much more financially stable and be able to put money aside every month for savings. That's a huge peace of mind for me.
I think Erin's made a great decision. She's going to be paying less than she was in a tiny little condo. This is a win-win.
Thank you so much.
You're it's very beautiful. Welcome.
You told me that there might be rodents up there.
There's only one way to find out. Pry them out carefully. You never know what's going to fall out.
I was so grossed out, I wanted to just turn around and call the whole thing off.
There it is. It's actually condensation coming from the duct line. Any moisture in the air is going to condense on that ductwork. We'll look at the calibration to make sure that that doesn't happen again. Good news is, no rodents.
No rodents. That's a huge relief.
When we came to look at this house, I noticed the moisture problems in the basement. And even though the leak isn't happening right now, I guarantee you the water is still there. Come up pretty quick. We're dry. We're dry. There it is. And we're wet. Oh, do you smell that?
Once that floor came up, it was just stench.
Let's get this out of here.
Go. Oh, right in the dumpster. That's a lot of moisture. So the back of the house here has been saturated in water probably multiple times. Do you see the different stains on the floor? All these white stains. I think this is more than just the leaking fridge. If you look at the crack in the foundation, look at the crack continues through the floor. What it looks like is that this whole section of the house has actually gone like kerplunk.
When Scott talked about the whole back corner of the house having just
gone ka-tunk,
that's right, yeah, dropped down, I was freaking out.
This part of the house is sinking. Erin sold her downtown condo and bought a house with potential for an income suite in the basement. You look like business time right there.
I feel it.
She needs to turn the basement into a moneymaker. But the cracked foundation could put her plan in jeopardy. The whole back of the house here, kerplunk, has sunk.
All I saw was dollar signs going ching, 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 and I...
You know, to have part of the house kind of sinking and settling like that, it's not great. However, it is fairly normal. Cracks in the floor, totally normal. This is very typical. This is your house naturally settling. Okay?
Okay.
It's totally normal to have a few cracks in the walls in a basement. However, there's also signs of water around this one. So I want to bring in my foundation guy, make sure we waterproof everything before we go ahead and finish the space. Let this dry out and let's move our attention over to the bedroom. As we know, the bedroom is a little tight. We need to make this room.
Yep.
We got you prettier, but we got a little further from the city. So let's go take a look.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
So pretty.
I like it.
It's a sign. This property is protected.
Protected, yeah. Wow, this is a very fancy dining room.
Fit for a king or a princess. It's a great space.
Beautiful.
Really nice. So bright. We got dog books, dog toys. Wow. Dog pictures.
And look at the princess mask.
And the princess mask. I mean, the place looks pretty good.
Yeah.
I don't have any major concerns yet. Nice staircase here. Upstairs, we find a bathroom in great condition and two neutral but good-sized bedrooms.
It's just kind of boring, but I can spice it up.
Sure.
Let's take a look at the master bedroom.
Wow! This is huge!
This is not what I was expecting.
This is
awesome.
Perfect for a princess.
We better check out this closet space.
Okay, good size.
Good.
You're happy with that closet?
Very.
Because I think you're going to be even happier in a second.
This is great. Oh, wow.
Oh, my gosh.
Look at the tub.
She's very quickly feeling at home here. So very quickly, I need to make sure we can make some money before she completely falls in love. Upstairs is good. Main floor is good. Question now.
Can we make money downstairs?
Oh!
Guys, don't be so disappointed. It's a bathroom.
I was hoping this was a separate entrance. It is not. It's a powder room. So a separate entrance would need to be put on this back wall. Unfinished. As I like to say, unspoiled basements.
Wow. Wow, it just keeps going.
Do you see what I see?
No.
I think I see something wrong here.
Okay.
And possibly right there.
Oh. You picked the right person to go shopping with you.
Yes.
Me. But she's doing pretty good, too.
Yeah.
It's not a big enough crack to be a structural issue. But guess what it is big enough for? Water coming through. And I can see evidence on the wall of the moisture. But typically, cracks like these, we can do an epoxy fill, which means that we can fix the problem from in here because she has saved up a good down payment and she's buying an income property. The only question now is, who's going to make the decision here? Practical Aaron or Princess Aaron?
Erin wants to trade in her cramped downtown condo for a home with some space, but she can't afford it on her single income.
I think in order to get onto the house market, I'm going to need probably a little bit of rent income.
We've seen three properties, and now she needs to make a decision.
My gosh, this is going to be a tough choice.
The detached bungalow would reduce her mortgage the most, bringing it down to $350 a month.
The first house is great in terms of the rental income.
You're living here for about the same cost as condo fees.
But it's a lot of money up front, and it's just so dated inside. I don't know if I can handle that.
I know it's a little bit ugly, but it can be fixed up.
Next, we saw the suburban beauty. That would reduce her mortgage to $750 a month.
It's so pretty. I mean, we know that I love how it looks.
We got you prettier, but we got a little further from the city.
It's so far from everything.
But to think that I could afford to live there is quite appealing.
The city bungalow would reduce her mortgage to $550 a month.
It's going to give you a good return on investment. Lots of space downstairs.
Whoa! You can just see how much water there is under there. It's the most affordable of everything that we've seen.
Yeah.
But we know that it needs work.
It's not as pretty and as spacious as house number two, mm-hmm. but certainly coming from my condo, it's tons of space.
That's right.
Okay. Well,
are you good?
I think I'm good.
Cool.
Let's go.
Yeah.
After considering all the options, Erin finally decided, and she bought the city bungalow.
I'm home!
It's so exciting!
It's within my price range. I can imagine myself living there, and I think that the rental property will be easy to find a tenant for.
Yes.
She got her home and income property for the asking price of $350,000.
This is my new home.
I forced her not to choose the suburban beauty because it was too far, too big, and your kitchen.
I know.
Yes.
I didn't pick the large bungalow because the asking price plus the renovation costs are just a little bit out of my budget.
Now that she has the house, it's...
Hey, nice to see you.
Nice to see you as well.
Good morning.
Are you guys ready to go in and have a look?
All yes, set. Absolutely.
Let's do it. Feast your eyes.
Oh, wow.
Like a split level?
It's almost a raised bungalow. So we're coming in kind of halfway here.
Okay.
So what we're looking for is to keep your mortgage as low as possible by finding something that's got great potential for an income suite. That is if... you're happy with the upstairs, because you need to be happy with your home, right?
Yep.
Good. And then I'll make sure you can afford it.
Great.
So let's take a look around.
Oh, boy.
Oh, wow. Still got lots of stuff left in this thing.
Come on, who's got a booth in their kitchen like this, huh?
Everybody.
These countertops are just climbing the walls back here.
I don't know. It is pretty dated.
See, this is probably a lot different than the condo you live in now.
Yes. The condo is completely updated. Everything is new. So I've been a little spoiled.
Don't discount this house right away. I know it's a little bit ugly, but it can be fixed up. Lots of living space in here. And these hardwood floors are in great condition. Look at these floors. Let's check out these bedrooms. That's going to tell us a lot more about the place. First bedroom, good size.
Cool. Can I check out this closet?
Please do.
I have a walk-in right now, and although I can walk in it, I don't know. It's a bit different than what I'm used to.
Even better. How about an entire room as a closet?
Down the hall, there are two good-sized bedrooms.
Oh, wow.
But under all that wallpaper and carpet, they're in great shape.
Hardwood floor is intact in every room, good. In every closet, in a whole place.
Okay.
I mean, the tile is ugly, but it is in great shape.
I know that Scott's going to help me out with the basement, but the upstairs is all me.
Question is, what's downstairs?
Oh, this is a lot of green.
So let's take a look at what we got up here. So this is good. This is actually what I want to see, is that we've got lots of room to put our sound insulation in there. And don't be deceived by all the dark paneling, which makes it feel small, because there's tons of room. Holy cow.
Oh.
All the single ladies to the bar, please. So, today we are serving up an income suite in the basement. How would you like yours?
Good.
There's only one way to find out. Pry them out carefully. You never know what's going to fall out.
I was so grossed out, I wanted to just turn around and call the whole thing off.
There it is. It's actually condensation coming from the duct line. Any moisture in the air is going to condense on that ductwork. We'll look at the calibration to make sure that that doesn't happen again. Good news is, no rodents.
No rodents. That's a huge relief.
When we came to look at this house, I noticed the moisture problems in the basement. And even though the leak isn't happening right now, I guarantee you the water is still there. Come up pretty quick. We're dry. We're dry. There it is. And we're wet. Thanks. Oh, do you smell that?
Once that floor came up, it was just stench.
Let's get this out of here.
Go. Oh, right in the dumpster. That's a lot of moisture. So the back of the house here has been saturated in water probably multiple times. Do you see the different stains on the floor? All these white stains. I think this is more than just the leaking fridge. If you look at the crack in the foundation, look at the crack continues through the floor. What it looks like is that this whole section of the house has actually gone like kerplunk.
When Scott talked about the whole back corner of the house having just
gone ka-tunk,
that's right, yeah, dropped down, I was freaking out.
This part of the house is sinking.
Erin sold her downtown condo and bought a house with potential for an income suite in the basement.
You look like business time right there.
I feel it.
She needs to turn the basement into a moneymaker. But the cracked foundation could put her plan in jeopardy.
The whole back of the house here, her clunk, has sunk.
All I saw was dollar signs going ching, 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 and I...
You know, to have part of the house kind of sinking and settling like that, it's not great. However, it is fairly normal. Cracks in the floor, totally normal. This is very typical. This is your house naturally settling. Okay?
Okay.
It's totally normal to have a few cracks in the walls in a basement. However, there's also signs of water around this one. So I want to bring in my foundation guy, make sure we waterproof everything before we go ahead and finish the space. Let this dry out and let's move our attention over to the bedroom. As we know, the bedroom is a little tight. We need to make this room 33% bigger. You ready to... Aha!
Okay.
All kitchen. And basically what we've done is we've just taken the original plan and we've shifted everything about 12 feet this way. And you actually get this extra room here.
Wow. This is good. This is good.
Let's get you girls suited up and put you to work.
All right.
It's that simple.
All right.
Looks easy, right?
Yeah.
Because it is easy.
Okay.
Here you go.
Okay.
Got it?
Oh, jeez.
You got that?
It's pretty heavy. Did it.
Nice.
Keep doing it.
One down.
Yeah.
250 square feet to go. Are you guys curling or are you doing a renovation here? Sweet! You think you're tough? I'm gonna put you to work. We'll just see how tough you are. This is going to be where the dryer vent is going.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll drill a pilot hole and then we'll get you on the SDS on the other side. You ever cored a hole through a foundation before?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
They're actually pretty tough. I won't lie.
Today. We'll see when we get down there. I got something to show you. We came in, we found some water on the floor over in the kitchen area.
Oh man, there's a puddle here.
Mm-hmm.
Or dry on this side.
The water seems to be trailing across the back here.
Take a little video here. Even though it's really tight quarters here, we're going to do our best to inspect it, try to find this problem and resolve it so we can finish up. There's a wet spot. Boom. Dude, it's soaked right here. Is that water dripping down? What are the odds that we just found that? You know what it is? It's pretty hot out.
It is.
I'll bet you she's turned her AC on and there's a leak. We gotta cut this wall open. Hold on. Okay, let's pull some insulation. Can you see it?
Right there.
You know what? Drip line is not in the...
It's just not as pretty as I'd hoped for.
I know. But you could take your time with the cosmetic upgrades required in the huge four-bedroom main floor unit. It's outdated, but in great shape. The real potential is downstairs, where we'd reconfigure the space to create a three-bedroom apartment with an open-concept kitchen and living room, perfect for the local student rental market. Brace yourself a little bit, because it's a bit expensive and it's pushing your limits. But from an investment standpoint, this house is killer. The house is listed at $430,000. And it needs a $50,000 renovation. Your total budget here would be about $480,000.
Okay.
But that's not the end result. You're going to get about $1,500 a month in rent.
Wow.
So that brings your mortgage payments down to about $350 a month. You're living here for about the same cost as condo fees.
When I hear the numbers, it does make good sense.
So let's go look at something that's a little prettier, maybe.
Awesome.
Sound good?
Sounds great.
All right.
Follow me. The this first property, although the price point is good, when you add on the renovation, it's over her total budget. But I'm trying to get her to look at the bottom line. Because if you actually look at what it's costing her every month, it's pretty low.
That would be a good investment.
Yeah, I think so too.
But I don't know, there's so many renovations to do. That kitchen was so old looking.
Yeah.
The second house is way out there. I don't know if I've ever been this far out of town.
Good morning. Erin wants to trade her cramped condo for a house with a yard.
I want to have a house of my own, but I'm going to need rent income.
The first house had some dated decor.
I don't know. It's a bit different from what I'm used to.
But the income from the basement could make it all worthwhile.
You're living here for about the same cost as condo fees.
Now I'm showing Erin how much her single income can buy her outside of the city.
Is this one a little prettier for you?
This one is very pretty.
I see you smiling already.
Mm-hmm.
So you wanted something pretty, you wanted something cute, but you also want that financial opportunity?
Yep.
We got you prettier, but we got a little further from the city. So let's go take a look.
Okay. Oh, wow.
So pretty.
I like it.
It's a sun.
We'd also update the kitchen and the bathroom to complete this cozy basement apartment. You'd live in the 3-bedroom suite on the main floor, which has been recently renovated and is in pretty good shape.
And I would say it needs at least $60,000 to put in an income suite downstairs. So you're in for a total of $410,000, which runs you about $1,550 a month.
Okay.
But I think a 2-bedroom apartment down there would bring in about $1,000 a month. So your real cost would be reduced to $550 a month. But you have to find a property that you're happy with, but that's also going to be affordable. It's going to be up to you to make this decision now.
Okay.
Erin plays up the whole princess thing, but I know she's also got a very practical side because she has saved up a good down payment. And she's buying an income property. The only question now is, who's going to make the decision here? Practical Erin or Princess Erin?
Erin wants to trade in her cramped downtown condo for a home with some space, but she can't afford it on her single income.
I think in order to get onto the house market, I'm going to need probably a little bit of rent income.
We've seen 3 properties, and now she needs to make a decision.
Oh my gosh, this is going to be a tough choice.
The detached bungalow would reduce her mortgage the most, bringing it down to $350 a month.
The first house is great in terms of the rental income.
You're living here for about the same cost as condo fees.
But it's a lot of money up front, and it's just so dated inside. I don't know if I can handle that.
I know it's a little bit ugly, but it can be fixed up.
Next, we saw the suburban beauty. That would reduce her mortgage to $750 a month.
It's so pretty. I mean, we know that I love how it looks.
We got you prettier, but we got a little further from the city.
It's so far from everything.
But to think that I could afford to live there is quite appealing.
The city bungalow would reduce her mortgage to $550 a month.
It's going to give you a good return on investment. Lots of space downstairs.
Whoa! You can just see how much water there is under there. It's the most affordable of everything that we've seen.
Yeah.
But we know that it needs work.
It's not as pretty and as spacious as house number 2,
mm-hmm.
but certainly coming from my condo, it's tons of space.
That's right.
Okay. Well,
are you good?
I think I'm good.
Cool.
Let's go.
Yeah.
After considering all the options, Erin finally decided, and she bought
that wall out 4 feet. We haven't encroached too much on the living space, which is great. We went out and looked at a bunch of properties.
I'm very happy I picked this house, and I just couldn't wait to see what the other half of it looked like. So, and now the downstairs is so much nicer than my side. It's a bit embarrassing, but it's amazing. I love it.
It was a challenge, but we got an income suite in here. And it was so important because you're doing this by yourself. When you're buying real estate on your own, there's no backup plan.
Yeah.
You have to pay the mortgage no matter what. So putting in this income suite was imperative. You bought this house for $350,000.
Yes.
You spent $50,000 on the renovation.
Yes.
So you've spent $400,000.
Yes.
You okay?
Yeah. Yeah.
I had an agent come by today and give me a new assessed value on the property. And it was suggested that your house was worth $435,000.
It's amazing.
I like to make sure you win twice, not just once. The cash flow, that's our goal, but the equity, hey, why not win on that as well?
Yeah.
So let's talk about the cash flow. And the real reason you did this is to help with those mortgage payments. You're paying $1,500 a month. We suggested with this renovation that you'd earn an extra $850 a month in rent from this space. And the number that she suggested was $1,100 a month.
That's so exciting.
That's so good. Oh my gosh. That's so much more than I ever thought.
So you're really only paying $400 a month.
That's so good. I feel so relieved about the finances to hear that it's, you know, increased the value of the home and that I'm going to be able to get a little bit more rent than I thought. I'm just really excited to be much more financially stable and be able to put money aside every month for savings. That's a huge peace of mind for me.
I think Erin's made a great decision. She's going to be paying less than she was in a tiny little condo. This is a win-win.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Oh, I get one too.
You did pretty good too, kid.
For more information about this show, please visit hgtv.ca.
Question is, what do we do with this?
You pour some wine and you get in. What
are
you doing with it?
Hello? What are you guys doing in
here? It's a $350,000.
This is my new home.
I forced her not to choose the suburban beauty because it was too far, too big, and your kitchen, and your
I didn't pick the large bungalow because the asking price plus the renovation costs are just a little bit out of my budget.
Now that she has the house, it's time to decide what to do with it.
Congratulations on the new home.
Thank you.
I want to focus on how to take this house, turn it into two units, and start getting you some cash. And you need to make one more big decision.
Okay.
So option number one, I want to start with an efficient wraparound kitchen with stainless steel appliances. In the corner, we'd install a four-piece bathroom with a tub. The entire apartment is going to get brand new, durable laminate flooring throughout, and on the other side of the rental suite, we'd have enough room to build two good-sized bedrooms. There's a few other things that need to be done. Fire and sound separation, fire doors upstairs. We will have a common laundry area when you first come down the stairs. And even work to be done outside because we need two parking spaces side by side. So your driveway is going to double in size.
And if the crack in the foundation is bad, I may have to waterproof that side of the house while we're at it.
You need to tell me, how much is it going to cost?
It is a $60,000 renovation. To bring in $1,000 a month.
Okay.
That's going to reduce your mortgage down to $550 a month.
Okay. Let's hear the second option.
Let me tell you what I thought for option number two. We start with this space. We add on to it by opening up this wall. So down here, we'll have a wraparound eat-in kitchen, but we'll have dedicated laundry as well. This will open up the whole space.
Like in option one, the large living area would get a fresh coat of paint and we'd lay laminate flooring throughout the entire apartment. The existing bathroom would get updated with a new sink, new tiles, and new lighting. In this options-only bedroom, we'd paint, hang new window treatments, and then this place would be ready to rent.
To end up with a self-contained one-bedroom unit down here, and then we put laundry upstairs for you. Because it's a cheaper renovation, some money left over for you to do some fixes upstairs.
Okay. How much cheaper is it?
Option number two is a $50,000 renovation. I believe it will bring in $850 a month, and that will reduce your mortgage to $650 a month.
That's a lot to think about.
Look, last big decision, then we get to work.
Mm-hmm. Ultimately, with option one, it's the
most right away. I know it's a little bit ugly, but it can be fixed up. Lots of living space in here. And these hardwood floors are in great condition. Look at these floors. Let's check out these bedrooms. That's going to tell us a lot more about the place. First bedroom, good size.
Cool. Can I check out this closet?
Please do.
I have a walk-in right now, and although I can walk in it, I don't know. It's a bit different than what I'm used to.
Even better. How about an entire room as a closet?
Down the hall, there are two good-sized bedrooms.
Oh, wow.
But under all that wallpaper and carpet, they're in great shape.
Hardwood floor is intact in every room, okay. In every closet, in a whole place.
Oh. Okay.
I mean, the tile is ugly, but it is in great shape.
I know that Scott's going to help me out with the basement, but the upstairs is all me.
Question is, what's downstairs?
Oh, this is a lot of green.
So let's take a look at what we got up here. So this is good. This is actually what I want to see, is that we've got lots of room to put our sound insulation in there. And don't be deceived by all the dark paneling, which makes it feel small, because there's tons of room. Holy cow.
Oh.
All the single ladies to the bar, please. So, today we are serving up an income suite in the basement. Ooh. How would you like yours?
Gutted. Straight up.
There's also a bathroom down here.
This is actually really good.
And a nice size utility room.
So the house itself, pretty awesome.
I need to see the backyard for the dogs.
Yeah. Fenced in yard.
Good. That's very important.
That's pretty
it's
big.
Pretty big.
Before we check in with the princess, let's check in with the jester. What do you think of the place?
I think it's a great place. I think it's got everything you need.
It could use a little more shine. It's just not as pretty as I'd hoped for.
I know.
But you could take your time with the cosmetic upgrades required in the huge four-bedroom main floor unit. It's outdated, but in great shape. The real potential is downstairs, where we'd reconfigure the space to create a three-bedroom apartment with an open-concept kitchen and living room, perfect for the local student rental market.
Brace yourself a little bit, because it's